Welcome to the FTA catch-up on Xreal Air 2 Pro. The first thing to acknowledge is that these kind of glasses will always make you aware of your surroundings, as it is not as isolated as the VR glasses. This certainly doesn't come as a surprise. But there is also the augmented reality feature that, as Wikipedia would say, I was hoping to have that interactive experience that combines the real world and computer-generated content. But is that what actually happened? Sadly, not quite. So far, the Xreal Air 2 Pro does offer a decent balance between isolation and immersion, but it falls short in terms of offering augmented reality. For now, it's more of a portable screen than anything else. There are actually quite a few things that the Xreal Air 2 Pro as a second screen could offer. One of them is the clear image. Once you have found the right nose pad, you will certainly enjoy a 1920 by 1080 resolution when using your Asus ROG Ally or macOS or even the Steam Deck. Also, the whole purpose of having the glasses is that there's no need for a big physical space in order to have a big screen, so you can actually enjoy a big screen without having the physical space. Another thing is the immersion control. It has three different levels of electrochromic dimming that can help to improve the clarity of the image when there's some light in the background. You can change from 0 to 35 to 100%, which is not completely dark, but it is dark enough. So there's something else I found quite handy, and that is that it is possible to see through the glasses and temporarily switch off the screen function with just two taps on a button located on the right temple of the glasses. So if you're watching a concert and then suddenly someone comes around you and talks to you, you can just simply remove the image with two taps, and there you go, you're in contact with the real world again. Something else is the support to get customized prescription glasses, or even a bit of room to insert some type of prescription glasses in between the Xreal Air 2 Pro. It is not officially supported or meant to use that way, but I think there's some room to put the glasses there if you need to, or while you wait for the prescription glasses to arrive. Something interesting I found as well was that the bridge of the glasses, so that part that is in contact with your face, doesn't really get as hot as it does with the Rokit AR Max. So it gets warm, 31.6 Celsius, but not that bridge of the glasses, but rather the right temple of the glasses, and it's actually not that uncomfortable. The front part of the glasses only gets hot around 23-24 Celsius during test. Xreal Air 2 Pro as an augmented reality device. The augmented reality can be achieved by using the Nebula app or getting the Xreal Beam. The catch here is that there are few things that will make it difficult to actually enjoy AR. The first thing to notice is that the Nebula app doesn't really exist for macOS or Windows. This means that although the glasses will work when plugged to the laptop or PC or Mac, it would be in practice like having a secondary screen. The app is getting better and quite buggy when I was trying to test it on macOS. So if we accept this limitation and decide to use the Nebula on Android, then we'll find that not all the smartphones are currently compatible. This is something that could potentially be a serious issue, because some phones don't even work for air casting, which is the way that the secondary screen would work for Android. Relatively new phones like the Asus Zenfone 9 will simply not work. On the bright side, some of the lucky ones that support air casting also support AR space. Those phones are the OnePlus 8, the Oppo Find X3, the Oppo Find X5, and the Samsung Galaxy S21. Last but not least, if we use Android and we do have a compatible phone, then there's the actual AR experience. There are not many useful apps, although there is a demo of some sort of virtual desktop that gives an introduction to what AR might look like in the future. There's an app to give you the impression that you are cycling or walking in different locations. There's a virtual pet, a web browser, and a YouTube app, but that's pretty much it. The experience is interesting, but not particularly exciting. So, after all this, who should buy the Xreal Air 2 Pro? Apart from early adopters or smart glasses enthusiasts, I would say that if you need a portable screen for watching movies or playing with your Asus ROG Ally, maybe you can give it a go. On the other hand, if you are after an AR experience or want to use these glasses as a second screen to work and use your keyboard, then maybe it's better to wait for the hardware and software to mature. Well, that's all for now. Thank you for reaching this point, and I hope you find some of this information useful. See you later. Thank you.